This question they asked to verify the result.
Cos inverse of minus x equal to pi minus cos inverse of x. So you want to verify both are equal. So we go with take like theta equal to cos inverse of minus x. We take this ellipse. Theta equal to cos inverse of minus x. Now the same term, if we take multiply both sides cos inverse, meaning we take cos, then they also take into cos inverse of minus x. Then you can able to eliminate, you get over minus x will come. You can think like that, otherwise one more way you can say to start this. Cos inverse will come this way, become a cos theta equal to minus x. Now instead of cos theta, what I am going to do in place? Now suppose cos pi minus theta, that we can write cos pi minus theta. Theta lies in second quadrant, if we have like that. In here only e minus theta, that means pi minus theta. Here pi by 2 plus theta. Theta lies in the second quadrant. In second quadrant, sine theta and cosecant theta are positive. So we have cos 180 minus theta. So cos to negative will come. Here 180, if we have only 90 or 270 only, you want to change the ratio. So we have only 180 degree. So no need to change the ratio. So theta is in second quadrant, is negative. Then it become a cos theta. Now multiply by minus 1 both sides, it become minus of cos pi minus theta equal to cos theta. So instead of the cos theta, I go and substitute minus of cos pi minus theta. So instead of cos theta, I go and substitute minus of cos pi minus theta equal to minus x. Now again, entire equation multiply by minus 1, then become a cos pi minus theta equal to x. Now as usual, when cos inverse come, it become cos theta. Then cos take that side, become a cos inverse will come. So pi minus theta equal to cos inverse of x. Now x in take minus theta to the next side. Cos inverse to bring this side, it become minus of cos inverse of x equal to theta. Now LHS are the x and right. Theta equal to pi minus of cos inverse of x. Now again replace by theta. Cos inverse of minus x. So already we assume that theta equal to cos inverse of x. Take your equation 1. So then by equation 1, instead of theta write cos inverse of minus x equal to pi minus cos inverse of x. It's a required result to verify. So now bring both are equal.